गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आर डायमेंशनल चैप्टर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड वन प्रिंसिपल, द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ होमोजेनिटी. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द होमोजेनिटी ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज हियर. सो वी नो दैट द सेम टाइप ऑफ यूनिट्स or quantities can only be added or subtracted. For example, let us see this example. Can we add 1 kg with 3 cm? Okay, so the answer is no, because 1 kg denotes mass and 3 cm denotes length. So mass and length cannot be added. Mass can only be added with mass only. Right? In the same manner, can we subtract 4 second minus 4 kg. Okay, so the answer is no, because from time, how can we subtract mass? So the simple idea of the principle of homogeneity is this, that if the two quantities are written in addition or subtraction, then it is compulsory that they should be denoting the same quantities. That means mass minus mass or mass plus mass only should be there. Okay, so basically the meaning of this principle is a physical equation will be dimensionally correct if the dimensions, that means the units, so if the dimensions of all the terms on both the sides of equations are the same. So let us take the example in the principle of homogeneity. We have the example 4 meter minus 3 meter. We know that the answer is 1 meter. Okay, that means if 4 meter minus 3 meters dimension is asked. So dimension means we have to use the symbol for that unit. So we know that 4 meter minus 3 meter is 1 meter. That means the dimension of 4 meter minus 3 meter will be length L. So in any equation, in our numericals, suppose somewhere L minus L is coming, we don't have to write 0. The meaning is that here one quantity of meter and here one quantity of meter are getting subtracted. So what will be the final dimension? So it will be same as the previous units. So like we know, 4 meter minus 3 meter is 1 meter. Here in this unit chapter, we are not interested in the number. We are interested in the unit. So you can see meter minus meter is meter only. So that's why I'm writing here L minus L is L only. So after adding or subtracting the two quantities, the final answer will have the same unit and dimension. Okay, so this is the example number one. Now let us see this example. What is the dimension of x minus y if x and y are displacement of the body? So you see, if x is displacement, that means L, and y is displacement, that means L. So L minus L answer will be L only. Okay, let us take third example. What is the dimension of v minus u if v and u are initial and final velocities? As you already know, in the Newton's equations of motion, u denote the initial velocity and v denote the final velocity. So if in any equation v minus u is appearing and we have to replace it by its dimension, so v is in meter per second, u is also in meter per second. They may have different values, like 4 meter per second minus 3 meter per second. So the answer is 1 meter per second. That means the answer will have the dimension L t power minus 1. I think this concept is clear to you. So the overall idea is, when the same type of quantities are getting subtracted, even if the units are same, you don't have to write the answer 0. You have to write the same unit. Okay, let us proceed to the next sheet. Now we will be solving some questions based on principle of homogeneity. So first question is, if x equal to a plus bt, where x is displacement and t is time, then find the dimensions of a and b. A and b are unknown quantities. So the idea is that we have to apply the principle of homogeneity that says that if two quantities are in addition, then they have the same dimension. And in the same manner, if two quantities are in equal sign, they also have the same dimension. So first of all, for finding a, we can take help of x only. Since x dimension and a dimension should be same, okay, like here meter is here, so here also meter should be there, then only they are equated. So they denote the same units or same dimensions. So x is displacement, this is given in the question. Now what is the displacement's dimensional formula? So that is length L. So this way our A answer is coming L dimension. Okay, so A is solved easily. Now let us come to BT. Okay, so in addition we have two terms A and BT. That means BT should also have the dimension of length only. Okay, because this is length, this is length, so this should also be length. So we can write that x equal to bt, x is length, so bt should be also length. Now b we don't know, but times dimensional formula we have to write capital T. And if we have to find b answer, so this t should be shifted that side, so l by t we will obtain. That means l t raised to power minus 1 will be the answer for b. Okay, so this way we have understood here how to get the dimension of a. So a equal to l and b equal to l t raised to power minus 1. Let us take question number second. If x equal to a plus bt plus ct square, where x is displacement, t is time, then find the dimensions of abc. Okay, now students, you have understood this question. Idea is same. Here in the addition, three quantities are given: a, bt and ct square. So they all are equated to x displacement, that means l. So all a, bt and ct square should be equal to x dimension wise. Okay, I am not saying value wise, it's dimension. So x dimension and a dimension should be same, x dimension and bt dimension should be same, and x dimension and ct square dimension should be same. So since x equal to displacement, displacement is denoted by length l, so a equal to l. So dimension of a we have obtained. Now here you do this way: x is length, b is unknown, and time t is capital T written. So b answer is l t raised to power minus 1. This t, when it shifts on the other side of the equation, it becomes t raised to power minus 1. Let us see third one. X equal to ct square, x is l, c is unknown, time is denoted by capital D, we have to put square because square is here. So finally c answer will become l, l is already here, this t square we have to shift here, so this will become t raised to power minus 2. We will be practicing these type of some more questions.